The next guest here on the storytelling stage, she started out as a Java developer, and today she is managing a team of 70 people. She's a daring risk taker, she has a deep understanding of tech, and she has a motto, which is, we can't do what we did yesterday tomorrow. Did you catch that? But it goes with this mindset that we need in the age where tech is moving really fast. So please welcome on stage, Rashin Kab. You have to help me with your last name, Rashin.
I will.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Hi,
how are you?
I'm fine.
Okay, so please let me know your last name.
Kabodvand.
Kabodvand.
Yeah.
Okay. But when I read up on you, I get like an energy boost almost, right? And at the same time, I get a little bit intimidated because I actually read on your LinkedIn page and I saw, I mean, your former bosses, your employees and people who are really like writing about you and rating you. And it sounds something like this. She can handle an enormous workload and still manages to get time for her employees. A great boss. She laughs a lot. She's not afraid of get out of her comfort zone. So it's like really good, of course, ratings you get there. So what's the secret sauce? How can you get so much done and then be nice at the same time?
Well, first of all, I did not pay for these people to do these great comments. But I think my receipt is that I really love what I do. And I believe that if you do have the passion for what you do, you will be able to handle big workloads. And personally, I really love see people grow, and everything I do today is for my consultants. So, and that gives me the energy. Mm.
But sometimes we hear about these great entrepreneurs, the guys, you know, like Steve Jobs or was an asshole. Basically, Elon Musk was not very nice either, right? Is not. So. So does it take an effort? Is it something, or is that something that is really good for the team? And
well, to be honest, I always say that either you love me or you hate me.
Really?
There's nothing in between. But I hope they love me. But I think to go back to what I said, if you see someone that has a passion for the things she's or he is doing, that will spare energy to other people. Of course, it's also about prioritizing, not doing everything, doing what you are good at. And I think that is really important, because if I would do everything and not doing it good, I would be pissed off, and that will share to the other organization.
But there are many, many stories, especially in tech, about women who are pushed down and not getting where they should be and so on and so forth. Pretty sad stories. And also about women who doesn't really like the industry, to leave the industry. So you are young, you are a manager of 70 people, very well liked. How can we help other young women to get this flying start in their career?
Well, as a wise person told me once...
Who was this? Your father?
No, actually it was our CEO, Niklas Flyborg. He said that we should always dare, share and care. And that is something that I see myself. I've always been not afraid of doing what I believed in. I was not afraid of doing mistakes, because I love when I actually do mistakes, because then I learn new things. And I think it's important to go for what you are aiming for and have targets and work to achieve those goals in your life. But also be smart and take like help from other people. That is something that I'm very good at. I always like see what other people is doing, and I always take the best thing of everyone, and then I create my way of it.
Mm. But bring us back a little bit. You started as a developer, right?
Yep.
And what kind of attitude do you have there in your team when you were just new coming in?
As you said, you like got a feeling of the energy when you read my profile. Well, I do have a lot of energy. Maybe not today because I've been meeting so many people. But I had a lot of energy when I started off, and it was like 7 years ago. I came into a really, really good senior team, mostly guys or just guys. And then my attitude was to change this, I mean, introvert culture that often is in, development teams or so on.
You took on this really tough task,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, and I become like an informed leader. We started off with like taking fika every morning and the evening. But it was, I joke a lot. So that also became one thing that we started to joke on. And I have a background a lot with sales. So I think that combining my role as a consultant with sales was something that I really liked. Because being a consultant is actually to be selling. You're selling yourself, you're selling the company, and you're selling your knowledge. And I think I believe that I shared this type of mindset to the group or to the team that I worked with. So I saw the development in the culture in the team when one and a half year later, one of my colleagues actually told me that, "Hey, Rashin, shouldn't we charge the customer for this development job that we did last week?" And then I saw the change. And,
yeah.
And that's when I realized that I want to work with coaching and developing people.
This was before you were actually the manager.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, and I believe that I had the capacity of doing that.
But sometimes I think that you come in with a totally different attitude than the rest of the guys in the room, right? And this time it turned out well. Other times it could be super hard.
Yeah.
So you get so much pushback.
Yeah, but I love challenge. Once I had one customer who actually called our service desk and he said that, "Hi, I want to talk with the one who developed this service." And the support technician asked, "Yes, I will connect you to her." And he said, no, "I want to talk with the one who actually developed the service." And she said, "Yes, I will connect you to her." So I've been facing that type of attitude, of course, but I love that. How do you do that?
How do you turn that around then?
Showing that I have the knowledge and the competence and that I have the answer on their question. So it's not about being female or male. Mm. So, mm.
But the competence and the technical savviness.
Yeah.
So is that what makes you such a good leader, that you actually not only have been a leader, that you really know the tech, so to say?
Yeah, I would say that is one of the reasons where I am today, and one of my success factor is that the deep insight into technology, both from the business perspective, but also from a human perspective, from a consultant who actually is working as a developer, where I can see myself, where would I be, what would I want to work with, and see the potential in people. Mm. And that's, I would say, is one of the... Mm.
So, if there is one thing then that you wanted to know when you were 20 about yourself as 30, I mean, it's always funny to look back and see.
When I was 20, like 10 years ago, I always wanted to be like on a high position. I wanted to be CEO. I wanted to have my own company, and I just wanted to have a high position. And I didn't understand why, because I thought that, well, if I have this high role, then I can just let everybody else work. And actually, it's not that way. I've actually realized that with power, it comes big responsibility. So if you ask my colleagues, they will say that Rashin never sleeps because she's working 24/7. So realize the fact that there is big responsibility.
But you still wanted to be a boss, right? Shouldn't take that back.
I don't know. I just wanted to work with technology in the tech industry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But fast forward, well, slowly forward.
Yeah.
Where are you by 50? Because you're already like a successful woman in tech. So 20 years from now, my age, baby.
Yeah.
Where are you?
What are you doing? Say that I am retired.
Oh my God. I get jealous now. There's no freaking way I can retire. But I'm sure you're better off. But you're not one of these people who are saying, no, I'm gonna work till I'm 75 because I know that I still will have energy.
I mean, I love to work. I work more than 8 hours per day. But I also love enjoying life and the people around me. So I think that I will not work as much as I do now.
I love that. I love that because a lot of people are just keeping that aura of that you have to work to be happy, you know? You can also have vacation and be very happy.
Yeah, I see myself on a like sunbed somewhere in Spain or something.
That sounds fantastic. Yeah. Guys, we have a few more minutes for questions, and I'm sure there are a lot of questions for Rashin. Please be brave and ask her something. There we go. Please tell us your name.
Hello, my name is Jay-Z.
Hi.
I'm new in the country. I'm here for 2 years. And as you, I'm a very extrovert person. Do you think that that helped you to grow in the companies, being extrovert and communicative?
I would not say it's due to the fact that I'm extrovert. I think it is because I've been believing in what I would like to do, and I always done that. Actually, I'm like the one person that does not do or follow processes. I always do my thing, and that could be a bad thing from like a managing perspective. But to be honest, that's who I am. I always done what I believed in, and that is something that I would recommend you to do.
Thank you so much for the question. Okay, let's go. We have another one, don't we? Okay, I have one. Are you managing people that are tough to manage? And can you see a challenge in that too?
Yeah, both, of course. I mean, there are different type of people with different type of personalities, with long experience and none experience. But I love when it's challenged because then I see that we can transform this challenge to something good, to a result, because I'm very result driven. I need to see result in everything. So I think that is more fun to have a challenge to work with. Mm-hmm. But it's always fun to see like self-driven people as well.
And people, when people grow in your hands, so to say, right? Well, when people grow,
yeah,
like, yeah.
Yeah, that's the best thing, yeah.
Okay, thank you so much, Rashin.
Thank you.
I wish you all the best on your journey to eternal vacation from 50
plus. To my retirement.
Yes, yes. If I live by then, maybe I'll visit you.
Yeah, you'll do. Okay. You can join me at Marbella.
A big applause for Rashin.
Thanks.